There is a new, very cool and useful feature on the GrandMA3 software called Recast. GrandMA3 Recast is a new way of being able to change your existing programming on your show file, and you can find it in the settings of all your presets. And you might think that this is not very important, but I think that this feature will make your life a lot easier as a GrandMA3 programmer, especially if you are touring your show and cloning new fixtures into your show all the time. In this episode of our GrandMA3 tutorial, I will show you how it works, and I'll try to explain why I think it's so groundbreaking that MA Lighting incorporated this feature into the GrandMA3 software. So let's get into it. To show you how Recast works, I've set up a new view here on the GrandMA3 onpc software, and I'm going to show you two examples of the different functionalities. So first of all, we have our new view here. I have a playback window up here. I have my 3D window up here. I have my sequence down here, and I have a fixture sheet over here. So let's take all our Vipers and put them into a color of some sort. Let's say we need them in red, so we turn them on at full, and we put them in some sort of position right here. There we go. We can store this as a preset, as we have done many times before in this tutorial series, but this time I've chosen an all preset. An all preset doesn't filter down the functionality as you would see position do. Position only stores the position values. Gobo only stores gobo values, and so on. All preset stores all values, so whatever you have active is going to be stored into the all preset. But this time I'm just going to clear out because I made a small mistake. We turn on all the Vipers, we turn them on at full, and we put them in the position we talked about before, like this. Let's store this into, there we go, into a sequence up here. So if we clear this one and say go to this one, we have our preset. So let's give it a color. We take all our Vipers again and we put them in red. Like this. There we go. And let's store this in our all preset. Now our all preset only contains color information. So if I choose all my Vipers and put them into the red color, I can store them in our sequence here in queue number one. So if we clear this one, they will stay red. So now I want to add some zoom information to this just as an example. Normally, if I put zoom information or any other value into this, it's not going to affect the programming at all. So let's try this. Let's go to focus. Let's take the zoom all the way down to zero, and let's store this into our preset right here. You'll see when I clear here, they go back to whatever they were doing, because the preset I programmed with, I chose all my Vipers, put them in red. And this preset at that time only contained the red information. I stored this in my sequence up here, and now the problem is that the sequence now only looks at the color. But the really, really cool thing is you can now go down here and say edit settings, and you can find this button down here saying recast preset. If I recast and I clear, you will see now the value has changed for the sequence number one. And it now contains the zoom information and the color information as well. And that is a really cool thing to do. I can see this functionality being really, really useful if you are like touring a show and you are cloning from one fixture type to another fixture type. And say, for instance, you have programmed your entire show on CMY colors or RGB colors. And then the fixture you're cloning to only has static colors. And you want to change all your programming so it contains the right colors, and you want to be a little bit more in charge of how the cloning process is going to be. So this is one of the use cases where I can really see it being helpful. So let's try something different. Let's say we choose all our Vipers again. We take the color out. Let's just put it in, maybe just put it in yellow. And then we add a gobo to it. So now it has a gobo. If we store this into the preset here and we say overwrite, it's going to remove all the information that it had previously. It had some zoom information and it had some color information. Right now we changed the color and we didn't store any zoom information, and we put a gobo in and stored that as well. So if I clear out here, it's going to go back to only the color preset we used before. The reason why it goes back to the color is the color, it already knew the color value. So we could change the color, we just couldn't change the gobo, and the gobo disappeared. So if I go into our settings right now and recast our preset, and we clear, you can see the zoom information disappeared because we removed it from this preset. And it added the gobo information and it changed the color information. So that's another way of using the recast. If you like this feature and see the value in it, I'm going to show you a much easier way to recast multiple presets at the same time. So be sure to stick around to the end of this video so you don't miss it. And if you enjoy this video and find it useful, be sure to give it a like. That's going to help my channel to spread out to more people on YouTube. Liking videos is a great and free way to support any YouTube channel. And please leave a comment below if you have any questions regarding GrandMA3 or suggestions for future topics we could cover in this tutorial series. I'd love to help you in any way I can. And if you are interested in GrandMA3 hardware, I have some links in the description for all kinds of different pieces of GrandMA3 hardware. For a better overview of all the different models, I have a special landing page with a lot of different GrandMA3 consoles. You can also find this link in the description. And a small disclaimer, the links in the description are all affiliate links, and that means if you decide to purchase some of the products, I will receive a small commission on the sale. So with that out of the way, let's continue learning GrandMA3 Recast. Recasting your presets through the settings menu is fine, but we need a faster way of doing it. So let's just set it up. We take all our Vipers, we put them in some sort of strobe mode here. Let's store this into our preset right here and let's clear. Once again, it stops strobing because it's only looking at the color. So if we want to recast that in a faster way, we just use the command line. We say recast, we say preset, we say 21.37. And the reason why we call it 21 is you can see our all preset is preset 21. As our gobo is 3, our focus is 6, and so on. So now we want to recast preset 21.37 because that's the preset number here. If I press OK to that, it's going to recast it through the command line. Another cool way we can do that is copy this information here. We make a new macro, we insert a new macro line, and we paste our recast preset in as we just wrote. There we go, and we can rename this one. Recast, there we go, and then we clear out here, and then let's say we want to remove the gobo information. We take our Vipers, maybe we double click on this one and we say remove, and we store this in our preset. We clear, and now we can simply press the macro we just made and it stops. So recasting presets is really, really cool. You can recast as we did here. We recasted preset 21.37. You can recast multiple presets here. 37 through, if we said through 500, it would recast all the presets in that range. So this is how recast works. GrandMA3 programming is kind of fun. And remember that we are still in the very early stages of the software. I'm sure that GrandMA3 software will evolve a lot over the next few years, just like the early days of the GrandMA2 software. Be sure to give this video a like so it can spread out to more people and subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss any future episodes. And if you're on the journey of learning GrandMA3 from scratch, I highly suggest that you watch this next video you can see on your screen right now. In this video, I'll show you some other cool features of the GrandMA3 software. I try to release one new video per week, so please come back if you want to continue learning GrandMA3. I hope to see you on the channel again sometime in the future, and until then, happy programming.